I'm in Bishop Headley High School, where they're trying out some interesting approaches as they prepare for the new curriculum. An innovative enrichment programme is helping pupils here to build stronger life skills and has opened up new opportunities for them to learn in different ways. In my annual report, I'm urging all schools to think seriously about how they are going to design a curriculum that meets the needs of all their learners. And reviewing teaching and learning is at the heart of this process. In terms of the sectors we inspect, preschool settings, primary schools, special schools, and the post-compulsory sector all continue to do well. This year, we have also seen improvements in all-age schools, independent special schools, and pupil referral units. But the number of secondary schools causing concern is too high. Improving teaching and learning is the most common recommendation for these schools. Outcomes for more able learners and provision for the most vulnerable have both improved overall. But the gap between how well disadvantaged learners do compared to their peers has not closed. The schools that are most successful at supporting disadvantaged learners take a community-focused approach and build strong links with the services that can help these learners and their families. Reforms in the post-16 sector have the potential to make young people's education experiences more seamless. Currently, too many school leavers do not always take up the learning opportunities that best meet their ambitions and interests. Overall, we're heading in the right direction. There has been progress with the reform programme and there is more collaboration. So head to my annual report on our website and find out more about your sector. Explore cross-cutting themes and find more case studies from providers like Bishop Headley to inspire your own practice.